A kind day to you all, I am Kinsmarck, and this is Let's Play Blameless, an indie horror game that I came across on Steam, I think. And I'm feeling calm and chilled, so I'm just gonna take this cool and soft. So, Blameless saves your progress automatically whenever you see this icon. Alrighty then, so I hope you guys can appreciate that. Let's see here. New game.
I'm an architect. Freelance, so I take job offers as they arise. So, when this guy called me,
I was relieved I could finally get a paying job. He said he needed help with interior design for his house that he was building. I always respected people who can do construction, so I naturally agreed to come and take a look. I already had a couple of ideas. It was already quite late, but he insisted on me coming over the same day. I tried to comply, because I didn't want to lose this offer. Drove there with my car. His house was all the way over in the suburban area, quite remote, but with other houses nearby, quiet place. The man met me at the front gate. It was a temporary fence, and the gate was made of rotting wooden planks. He started showing me around the yard. It seemed weird that there was a large garbage container blocking the way, so we had to go through the garage to get inside the house. He took me through the rooms, so I started looking around. At one point, I saw a stain, and at first glance it seemed like brick dust. But then I realized it was blood, spilled on the floor. I thought that maybe there was another worker who got injured, so I turned to tell the man. That's when I saw his hand raised to hit me. He was holding a metal rod. Before I could defend myself, he hit me in the head. I must have passed out. I don't know how long I was out. When I woke up,
I started playing. Alright, credit there. That was actually a fairly solidly acted intro. Architect man, I think you're paranoid. I mean, he did hit you over the head and all.
That hurt.
Oh, cool. He actually still speaks. It's just, that ain't blood. It's just not. It's paint. Because that's not the color that it dries. So, yeah. Alright. Let's see. Man, this is pretty gorgeous lighting. Like, this game is well put together, visually. Like, so far, that's the one critique. Because, that isn't the color that it actually stays. So, let's see. These little question marks. Like, it almost seems like this is, like, a point-and-click game that I can move around the environment of, so kind of cool. Whoa. Okay. Click right mouse to reverse an action. Okay. So I can actually use the table vise. Interesting. Why would I do that? What are you? Oh, cell phone. I've got a Nokia. Alright, clearly it's not an actual Nokia, because otherwise it wouldn't have those cracks. What is this? Whoa. Oh, I can, like, turn it over. Press I or mouse wheel up and down.
No way it's gonna work anytime soon.
I mean, it's just the screen that's cracked. Alright, fine. Can I put it away? Can I not have that hovering in front of my face distractingly the entire time? No, apparently not. Not any way that I can find, anyway. Alright, that's jarring and unpleasant. Can I click on the smear on the floor that is actually paint? No? Alright. Oh, hey, there we go. Alright, I just had to actually click a thing, I guess. Whoa, hey. Pipe. Come at me, man! So, okay, that's just dust. Kind of feeling a somewhat. Can I just, like, use this to smash out a window and they're all painted dark from the inside? That just occurred to me. Creepy sign. Oh, hey, ceiling thing. like a light or a panel into like another level. I actually don't like that the question mark things fade away as I get close, because it makes it unclear as to which things I actually can interact with. Okay, there we go. Oh, alright, apparently for that written right-click drops it. This game has consistency issues. Uh-huh, okay. So that's the attic. Alright, so I'm not in a sub-level, I'm in a ground level. Seriously, can't I just smash through these? There aren't, like, iron crossbars or anything. Saw. Can I cut through that? I assume it is nominally too high, even though I could definitely reach that. Alright. Can I open these? I can. What are you? Hammer! Alright, well, let's just... I'm gonna start collecting all of my tools here near this table. If there's some way to actually put those in my inventory, I have no idea what that way is, because... Like, the phone I picked up and actually put it in inventory, and then... The other things, I can't... I don't know. Door. I
can't get further through here.
Then pick up the hammer and smash it! Maybe. Hopefully. Can I take that? Ooh, that's a large... No, that's not a pipe, that's just a piece of wood. Hammer. There we go. Can I smash the hinges off? Maybe. Nope. Alright. So, already suffering severely from point-and-click syndrome, there is a specific solution to solve this that it wants me to figure out instead of taking the Occam's Razor, a simple solution, and just do things the easy way. Alright, game. I'll play things your way. Another vice. What's with all the vices? Alright, so there's the table vice, there's the hand vice. That's considered a, what is it, a claw? There's actually a term for those, I forget exactly what it is.
This bloodstain does not look like it's the result of a banal injury.
No, it doesn't. It doesn't look like it's the result of any injury, because that's not blood. I know, I'm gonna keep harping on that, because it's like pinkish. It's not even the vibrant red of fresh blood. Anyway, because for anyone wondering what it actually looks like that doesn't know what I'm on about, blood does not stay red for long once it leaves the human corpse. Or living frame, should one survive such an injury. No, it turns, like, dark, muddy brown pretty fast. So, let's see here. Alright, I can't interact with this door at all. Can I use this... metal pipe, whatever this is? There we go! Alright, something a little longer... What? Pull on this now?
I can't turn it by hand.
Oh, okay. I need to attach something to the end of it then. Alright, let me use the little L claw thing. Because if I can screw that onto the end of it, maybe I can turn it? Or I could do something else. Alright. Jesus. I feel like I'm missing something and I just can't tell what it is. Can I move faster? I can! Alright, cool. Well, at least there's that. So I don't have to spend as much time just meandering around. Alright, for some reason, it still has this little hover-over question mark on this. Whoa. Alright, I guess I'm taking a closer look at the paint spill.
Seems fresh.
No, it doesn't.
Blood hasn't completely dried out yet. It's
still not the right color.
This looks like something that's being dragged across the bloodstream.
We can agree on that. Alright. Alright. Not sure why that needed a zoom in. Cool though. Whoa, hang on. What? There's something really specific here. Oh! I can turn this on. Alright. Can I take it with me? Alright. Is that meant to eliminate something important? This is really one of those that you just hover your mouse over everything and just see what the game wants you to do, instead of figuring out what should one do. So, apologies if I'm coming off incredibly critical of this, it's just... There's a reason I don't play many games in the point-and-click genre that, even though this technically isn't one, it plays like one, because I just find them aggravating in their arbitrary problem-solving solutions. They aren't at all immersive or satisfying for me, so call that personal, as in not necessarily objectively critical, just personal preference. All right, I feel like that power line that's strung across this area is there for a reason, because it cuts across like the focal point of this room, so like it must serve some function. Ooh, wait a minute, hold on. All right, it's either plugged into the door or into something past the door. Oh, now I can click on the door. Again, consistency game.
Why would he hit me and then lock me in here?
Why would you not let me question that when I first hovered over this? That's not even an important question to ask. All right, so I have to do things in a certain order then. All right, I didn't mean to come at this game this critically. It's just making some strange choices that aren't making for a smooth experience. Like, it really feels like I'm in a game, not in a stressful, oh god, I just got nailed over the head scenario. Alright, so I'm gonna need to put something in the vise, clearly. So what is that something? And then there, can I use this other side of the table vise? No, I can, wait, maybe? Hold on, or was that that? Yeah, okay, that was just the mouse hovering over the needle-nose pliers. So, it says I can't turn this thing without something on the end of it. So I need to find something to put on the end of it. I can't use the clamp, for some reason. Can I smack the end of it with a hammer? That wouldn't make a whole lot of sense. Let's just try things, though. Nope! I cannot. Alright. Can I put the pipe on the end of the stick?
The rod is loose.
It is loose. It's so loose that it's hanging on its own. So very loose. Maybe I should put it on the table clamp? Can't do that. Should I put the L clamp on it and turn this into a handle, even though it has one already? I don't know. Let's find out. Nope. Alright. Oh, hey. Pliers! Alright, sure. Let's roll with that making sense. Hang on. Prior to heading upstairs, hammer, utility, and self-defense tool. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Alright, so this is actually an attic and not just a
shit,
another
dark
level. Uh-huh. It is. So, see to crouch. Alright. Heh. Storm is coming in. Wait, no it isn't. Those are dragging sounds. Those were definitely dragging sounds.
There we go.
So I can get to another part of the house. Alright. So this guy that captured me seems like sort of a Craigslist killer type. Alright, new area. So, the hell were all those other things for? Like all the other tools. I only used like a few of them. Maybe I'll have to go in there again and get stuff later? Like I'll open that door at some point? That's inviting. Okay. So, there's a wallet there. Let me drop the hammer somewhere I'll remember. I'll start leaving things in light. That way I know where they are. That looks like a light fixture. Alright. Wallet. Is that mine? Ooh, hey. Okay. Zoom! Enhance!
The library card belonging to Helen Woodward. How did it get here?
Gee, I wonder. Okay. I guess that's all there is to this? I guess we're not going to investigate further and figure out what commonality we might share with her, although I'm sure she's some kind of contractor that, like me, was lured out here for serial killing murder. I don't know. I know contractors are hard to work with, man. I know they're frustrating. You don't have to kill them, though. Just leave them shitty Yelp reviews. That'll sink them in the end. See this? I need a hammer that I took with me to just smash this open. Hell, I could kick that open. That is some old-ass wood. What the? Those weak little wires! And no, these planks are not attached to any wires. Kick them, smash them, walk away. Call cops! Let SWAT come raid this place and shoot the psycho dead. That would make too much sense though. So we're gonna continue on playing the game the way it wants to get played. Alright. Little cement smoothie outy tooly thingy that I don't know the name of. See, look! Red paint! It was a paint spill! I actually wonder if that's a real thing in the game now. If this is all just a giant misunderstanding, the guy was just like, I'm sorry, there was a spider on your head, and I'm a horribly arachnophobic person! I was just trying to save you from the horrible spider! Okay, cutters. Alright, what can I use the cutters on? And a crowbar! And something else on the windowsill. Cool, so this room has all kinds of treasures and treats. Okay, what are you? Your pack of screws? Yeah. Alright, so it's full stalker mode. If there are anomalies, I am prepared. So clearly I'm gonna have to use these for something. Alright, let me just keep on collecting my... What? Did I drop it or did I pocket it? Oh, I pocketed it. Okay, cool. So I have the screw with me now. Good. Okay, extra pipe. Good to know. What else? Crowbar. You are coming with me, and I will Gordon Freeman anybody's face off. How is it stuck? Okay. Alright.
It's stuck underneath the beam.
Alright, can I pry it out with this? I cannot. Alright, sure. Can I, like, clip the end off with these and just take the rest of it? Because I only really need one end. Apparently not. Alright, can I smack the end of it with a hammer and pop it loose? Let's see if that is a thing I can do. Of course it isn't! Because let's just exhaust everything that makes sense and go for the most arbitrary solution to any problem that arises. Because point and click. Alright, power line. Do you lead anywhere important? Let's see. You come around. Hold on. Random plank I can pick up. So I can pick up this one. Can't pick up any of these. How in the hell should I have known to hover over this one plank to do something with it? Come the hell on! So anyway, wire. Wire leads to power strip. Can I? Nope, I can't manipulate the power strip in any way. Ooh, wait a minute, wait. Wires! And wire cutters! Idea! Light bulb! Let's see if I can actually... There we go, I forgot I could sprint. Heh. Alright. And... Clippy snippy!
The wire cutters are broken.
Sure! I've got screws, let's fix them! Let's do that! Alright, plop them in the light. Whip out the screws. There we go. You can interact with any objects in front of you. Try the screw and the wire cutter. Yeah, that's what I'm doing. What do you want from me? Hang on. Let me try this again. Right. So, whoop. Oh, cool. Okay. I had to manipulate each arm of it. All right. That's needlessly complex. How do I? Can I put the screw in the hole? That's what she said. Click on the actual screw. There! Tools master! Okay, for a second I couldn't tell if the screw was actually there. Oh, this game! Let's just clip the damn wires. Let's do the thing. There we go. Convenient that all of these parts necessary for doing this are all left in here. It's almost like it's some crazy psycho's game. He's wanting me to play along with. You know what? I'm just taking these with me. Because in a pinch, I can still clobber somebody over the head with them. Or I could put them down, because Lord knows, you just can't open doors with a single object in your hands. Cool. That was hard. Let's do this. Take anybody with me. Okay. Is this clippy, windy chain link fence? This is the thing preventing me from escaping to freedom, is it? Can't just hop this. Hit one too many of the Krispy Kremes, graduated architect school, and just decided, screw it! I'll just let myself go!
Shit.
Yeah, sure. Okay, cool. I know you're trying to make it spooky. This game is far too frustrating to communicate any amount of spoop. Oh, God. Ooh, wait a minute. Hold up. Oh, I guess it was just my falling clippers that... So I can't wander around with anything in my hands, because otherwise I'll miss the hover-over prompts. Alright. He shut the door, didn't he?
No way going back through here. I don't even want to go back.
I do! Because there was an easily hoppable fence there! This character's an idiot. Okay. Alright, autosave point. Cool. Empty thing. Can I unplug something? Alright. Whoa, what country am I in? Because that is not English. Alright. Let's see. Well, I guess the only way to go is down. So let's do that.
I don't like the look of that dark corridor.
Corridor? Seriously, dude? You worried about flicking on the lights? Alright. Oh, hey! I'm outside!
Finally out of the house.
Cool. That felt too easy. I'm gonna check the rest of the stuff in here first. So there is a cement mixer out there. Can I open this door? I cannot, because it lacks a handle. Alright. So, let's see then. That's easily hoppable. Hold shift while moving to run. Why is that a thing I should need to do? Come on, game. Trying to scare me here? Alright. Seriously, that is... incredibly easily hoppable right there. Like, there's even this convenient pile of stuff to hop onto first. Okay, sure. I'll just keep hanging out here, because I guess I like it here. Locked. Hole in the ground that looks like it at one time had a ladder leading down into something. Did that cement mixer get used to horribly inter someone? Probably did. Alright. Either that or they're just filling in a well because it's not usable anymore. Let's go for the morbid answer, though. Because that's fun. Alright. Can't open you. Can't open you. Seriously, about that whole hold shift to run thing. What was that about? What the? Okay, y'all are saying this too, right? The disappearing shrub? Alright. Phantom shrubbery. Creepiest thing in the game so far. Pipes that I can't pick up when I could pick up others earlier. More inconsistent pipes. Alright. A shed. Peekaboo. Can I... Oh. Okay. Sure. Riveting. There we go. That was necessary and doesn't feel like a waste of my time at all. Alright, plenty of tools. And more red paint! Yeah, this is definitely trying to tell me that the character just doesn't know what the hell blood looks like. That's my interpretation, anyway. Because why the hell else would they put red paint all over the environment? Like, I think that's intentional. I hope it's intentional. What are you? You're at, ooh, what are you?
Broken.
Broken what? Is it just a ladder thing? I don't know. What is this? Whoa, jeez, okay. Dairdrew Constructions to Simpson Hopkin, 38 East Highlands, Lightwater. From Anna Catwell, Dairdrew Constructions, 115 Morrison Street, Lightwater. 13th of July, 2001, so this is set a while ago. Subject, final reminder letter. Dear Mr. Hopkin, this is to inform you that according to our records, as of July 12th, 2001, we still haven't received received back the scaffolding or the three suspension ladders you borrowed from the Dairdrew Construction Stores on 7th of June of this year. Please return the scaffolding within 14 days upon receiving this letter. Should you choose to ignore this appeal, we will be passing this matter to a collection company, which will be obliged to forcibly remove the scaffolding from your possession. To recover any fees or penalties incurred by such action will be your sole responsibility. Note, you will not receive any more reminder letters from us. Yours sincerely, Anna Cadwell, Account Manager, Dairdrew Construction. Okay, cool. All right, got it.
13 July.
Oh, God! No! Put the ladder down! Cool. Okay. Apologies to that actress. I'm sure she did a fine job. It's just I didn't realize she was actually going to do a job at all, and so I already read it. So, moving on. Is there anything of use in here? Or am I just learning that this guy is a deadbeat client for construction companies? Oop. Case. Oh, come on! That looks so important and inviting! Fine. And what is that? Some other letter, I guess, that I just don't think is important for some reason. Okay. Ladder. So you go up there. There's a ladder in there. So clearly, I need to fix that one somehow. And then get up there for some reason. So I can get on the roof and hop the wall! Okay, alright. Picking up what you're putting down. Ooh, hello. Oh, hey. More of these things with the ladders on the inside. Still not sure what that's about. Well, alright. Whoa, hold up. I could have sworn I saw something in that window. Maybe it was just light reflecting off of it, strangely. I'm also not cutting this just because...
This must be one of the three suspension ladders mentioned in the letter.
Mm-hmm. Thanks for stating the obvious there, friend. I don't feel like spending multiple episodes on this, so this is just going to end up one long cut. So I need to fix this little part. That's what I'm picking up here. Right? Right. So, how would one do that? With tools that I probably haven't found yet, is very likely the answer. Can't pick up any of those. Or I just find another one. So apparently, if that's one of three, then there's a couple more scattered around here. I guess that's just there so that I know what I'm looking for? Okay. Is there some kind of electrical power relay thing? I don't know. I am not electrician. I cannot say I am expert in such matters. Right.
More dark rooms.
Mm-hmm. So... Seems like there isn't anything of use here. Ooh! Oh! Fine. Rebar. Lots of rebar. Heavy-duty rebar. Okay. Can I pick one of these up so I can use it as a friggin' mallet? Smack somebody in the face if they come charging at me out of the darkness? No? Of course not. Why ever would I do that? Why is self-preservation the least of my priorities? Thingy.
Why is everything always locked?
I'm asking that same question, my man. I really am. Alright, so padlock. So I just need something to smash that off with, right? Or if I can find a key, I could actually unlock it. Alright, so... Locky smashy doodad. Ooh, you have a convenient lever that I can't manipulate. Alright, fine. Ooh, what are you? You're just a smear on the floor. Alright, so there was a key in this cabinet thing. Can I pull it out now that I know I might need one? Of course friggin' not. Okay. I feel like I'm missing something in here. Like, that letter, and just knowing that there are these yellow ladder things. It's not the only reason to come in here, is it? I mean, surely there's something. And you know, I think one of the things that irks me most about point-and-click games, like, it isn't necessarily just the fact that one has to abide arbitrary problem-solving. It's the fact that they pretty much require one to metagame. And for those that aren't familiar with that term, metagaming is completely setting aside all immersion, all consideration of character knowledge versus player knowledge, and playing the game keeping in mind that it is a game. And thinking of how to work within the formulae and structures of a game instead of trying to figure out the scenario that the game is meant to represent. I think that, honestly, in the most critical of fashions of description, is the thing that gets to me about a lot of point and clicks. That at this point, I pretty much just consider this a three-dimensional point and click, because it plays exactly like one. All right, maybe I missed something inside, or maybe now something will highlight that I may have missed the first time, because come to think of it, I never came through this creepy dark hallway that spooked him out so much. So, let's see. Can't see anything. The music is awfully excited about itself. Whoa. Those are shoes! Yep, those are shoes.
The hell?
Mm-hmm. Yep, yep. She's dead.
She's dead.
Uh-huh. Got any ID on ya?
I don't want to look at her face.
Well, I mean, don't look at her. Look at her pockets, dude.
It's dust.
Corpse dust!
Similar to what I found upstairs on the floor.
Uh-huh.
I gotta get out of here and call for help.
I agree.
She was being dragged over here through the house.
Whew, this guy's real fond of stating the obvious, and that's a massive pet peeve of mine. Are we finished clicking on her? Alright, cool. There's something over here. Ooh, she has something in her hand. Ugh. Keys! And a note. 3P East Highlands.
Was she invited here too?
Clearly. Take that. Take the keys. Was that 1313? Okay. Alright then. Anything in your rear pockets? Ooh, maybe. Oh, no, that's her hand. Seriously, does she not have, like, a wallet or a purse or anything near her that I can check her ID and confirm whether or not it's one of the other contractors I've read in letters and stuff? Alright, well, whatever. I would also think he'd have smelled that. Ooh, flashlight. Of course. Oh, hey. Wait, what? This is not how you flashlights. Game, what are you doing? Okay, alright. I'm assuming I have limited power for this thing, so sparing use. Alright. That's lit up for some reason. Or is that just spray paint? I guess that's just spray paint. Okay. Huh? Anything in here? Yep. Can't open that really low poly cabinet for some reason. Okay. Oh, what the hell? What is that? Was that always? Oh, is that what this thing controls? It is. Why? Why even? Alright. Sure. Let's just move on. I have the keys. Alright. So, let's go. Keys! Two gates! Apply! Oh, right. I should actually pull them out, shouldn't I? There we go. Click. Just phase right through that lock. Can I take those with me? Yeah, there we go. All right, cool. Finally, something that makes sense. Flashlight. What's in the case?
Anything useful here?
Ooh, hello. Investigator. What are you? What's this? I have no idea. It's just some little cylindrical thing. All right, whoa.
I believe this thing can open fuse boxes.
I'll take your word for it, my man. Pocket that. Take the pliers. And can I just take this whole thing with me? Like, wait a minute. These are the same tools that I had in the first area. Coincidence? I think not. Apparently I just can't take any of the rest of those, so alright. I have no idea what that is. What are you? Some other fuse something or another. Another hammer! That I can't take! Have I mentioned the thing about consistency? So where was another fuse box? Was there one in this little shed, maybe? I feel like there was. And I felt incorrect. All right, was there one in here? Maybe. Upstairs? I could swear I saw one. There we go, this thing. Yeah. Aha! All right. Sweet! Ooh. Honey, if the circuit trips again, first turn on the RCD switch, the smallest one, and then the rest of them, the orange one last. Make sure you first hear a click after you turn the RCD on. It may take a couple of seconds, otherwise it will trip again. I need to take a look at this before we hand the keys over to the new owner. Alright, so... RCD, smallest one, then the rest, orange last. Okay. Is that... this one?
RCD240.
Cool.
Test monthly. This switch looks important.
Yeah, sure, let's flip it. Why not?
RCD240.
Yeah! Let's flip it! Let me guess, you want me to actually, like, read this? Uh-huh.
Honey, if the circuit trips again...
Shoot me now! Can I do it now?
RCD.
Yeah, it looks important. Can I do the thing?
RCD2, these are already on.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm! Yeah!
Honey,
yeah! Uh-huh! Yeah! Cool! Again, I'm sure he did a fantastic job. I can read for myself, though. I am a grown adult, thank you. What does this game want from me? Can I take the thingy off of that and use that to flip it, even though that's horribly unsafe because it's introducing metal into an electrical circuit? Yeah, it looks really important. Let's do the thing, not staring at a wallet. And this game should not pose this much of a challenge just to do things. What's in this? You gonna read something to me? The fuse box opener is locked in the old house in my... Cool, I already know that. Did I need to read this?
The fuse box opener is locked in the old house.
Is it?
In my duffel bag.
I'd never have known. The reason I'm criticizing these things having a voice so much, like, yeah, having voice acting in a game is always, like, impressive, I guess. Even though these days, because it was really only ever impressive because of memory issues, and that's a moot point at this point in game development. Is I have no idea who these people are. I don't have voices for them in the character's head, so these are just voices in my head that the character is arbitrarily assigning to them. That is not immersive as the player. The player should find these and wonder, like, who wrote this exactly? It just doesn't work. So now that I've read that and gotten this open, yeah, it sure does look important, and those sure are on. Oh. I can only hope, from the few slots remaining in my inventory, that this game is mercifully short and I'm closing in on the end of it because I've only got a few things left to collect. I have an idea, because these things are plugged in to other things, clearly, so I'm gonna follow where this red wire goes first. What the hell?
The dragging stain again.
Alright! That's nice! Do I need to... Because there's a corpse downstairs. Yeah, I know. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Alright, at least that's closer to the proper color. So, anyway. Red wire goes... Oh. To that. What about the dark wire? It goes out the door that I can't get through. Cool! Oh, hey. What the hell is that? That's... a circle. Like, that's the same color as the bloodstain. Even though these look like they're... like, the little dribble of paint that would come out of a paint can if you're, like, hauling it around in a hurry. Like, that's really what that looks like. So, God, this game is sending such confusing messages. Like, is it actually... do I need to actually, like, follow these drag marks so that he'll comment on them and trigger whatever it is I need to do to progress? Okay, well, now that I've got a flashlight in here, is there something else I can see? So, like, yeah, she's dead Zors. Uh-huh. Hole in the wall, right? Gotcha. Pile of trash. Uh-huh. Probably pile of other corpses, really. What if it actually was paint, and the reason he didn't comment on the smell is because there is no smell, and this whole thing is just at the end like, YOU GOT PUNKED! I almost hope that's the ending, because of how nonsensical this whole, like, murder mystery is shaping itself up as. I have no idea where to go from here, because clearly, like, I know it wants me to do something with that fuse box, but... what am I to do? I've clicked on everything!
Locked.
I have keys. Keys I can reuse. Alright, finally, something to do. What was the point of the fuses, then? What the hell sound is that? Alright. Hang on. Yoink! You're coming with me. Because you're handy. Okay, another power
thing. The way out.
There are several ways out, sir! You've just chosen to take exactly none of them. Okay. So... table saw. Can I use the table saw? Always mind one's footing around a table saw, just in case one falls over. Because, you know, it happens. And people die. Kind of a lot. All the time. Ladder! Alright, cool. I know where you go. So you're coming with me, Mr. Ladder. We're gonna hang you up in your place of honor. And then maybe I can climb up on the roof and hop out and go that way. And then I can forget all about this and call the cops and then, you know, just let the court system sort it all out. Alright. Climber. Cool. I see a skitty silent. City skyline even. Come on. I don't want to hop down right here because this is a narrow choke point. I want to climb up on the roof, go that way, and hop off on that corner where I can hop onto that hill and not get stuck in this little narrow pass. That's what I want! Can I have that game? Of course I can't, because that would make too much sense. Alright, sure, put me in the choke point that I'm sure I'm gonna get ambushed in. Come on. Come at me. Me and my underlit flashlight are gonna smack you upside the head. Yeah, hi, how's it going? he's so threatening!
Get away from me!
Alright. This is supposed to scare me, isn't it? Hi. Cops! Yes! Cool!
Stay where you are.
He framed me, didn't he? Yeah, sure. Okay. I am? Cool. As long as it's not getting stuck here.
But I didn't do anything.
Get on your knees now.
Do as they say.
Are under arrest.
You're gonna go to court and get acquitted because none of your prints are on. Well, actually, they probably are on murder weapons, considering how many tools I've had to touch.
This is what happened. Chasing me with a rod in his hand. He must have hidden when he saw the police cars pulling up to the gate.
Mr. Malcolm, we searched the yard thoroughly and didn't find any evidence suggesting there was another man.
You didn't look very hard.
He was there. He was the owner who called me.
The former owners sold the house due to personal financial problems 2 weeks ago. They moved to a different town on the other side of the country. The private company who owns it now proved all their employees were off-site, having a team building activity that night.
Could have been somebody else!
How could you not find evidence of him? I'm telling you, he was there.
I heard you. Our officers got a phone call from one of the neighbors reporting lights coming on in the house and suspicious person moving on site.
Suspicious person?
They gave us your description. They never saw another man.
How could that be? This doesn't make any sense.
Let's cut the crap.
What?
It does make pretty clear sense to me. I have to say that I honestly don't believe any part of your bullshit story that you're giving me here. Everything suggests that you murdered that woman.
No, I
found the victim's blood on your clothes and your hands. You had the victim's wallet in your pocket.
Wait.
And the officers caught you fleeing the crime scene. You, no one else. Guess whose fingerprints match the ones we found on the victim's body, huh? I don't know why you murdered that woman, but I'll guarantee you're never getting out. You're going down, Mr. Blameless.
Oh, this cheery music. Oh, I love it. Maybe it knows how funny and ridiculous it is. Because that was a stupid story, I'm sorry to say. Like, I hate to just smash on somebody else's writing. That was contrived in the extreme. So, contrived story, and if the people that have gotten off on murder in the past, I shan't name names because I'm not about that, you guys know the prime examples, because there are a lot of them, have gotten off the hook when there was... The hell? Okay, could things stop minimizing on me? I'd love it if they could. Alright, cool. Jeez, this has a janky ending. I am sorry. Sure, the character's prints are on maybe murder weapons. They're not on any part of the corpse except for, like, her hands where I pried them open to pull keys out of them. Didn't touch anything else. And I saw other sets of footprints that any CSI group worth any cent of their paycheck can just check and see, oh, that doesn't match the shoe print of this guy. So yeah, there was another person there. So I know they were trying to go for, like, the aggressive, like, the hard-boiled detective, I'm not taking your story, doesn't come across as convincing. He comes across as an idiot. And I'm sorry to say, the actor that did his lines, as compared to the main character's lines, they are in different realms of acting ability. So, who? I can't necessarily sugarcoat this, because I know you guys could see how I actually felt the entire time, so honest consensus, I'd never play this game again, and unless you're really into point-and-click games, because that's basically what this is, I wouldn't recommend that you do either. I do know, or at least I assume, that I missed a few things, because there were those extra couple of slots in the inventory that I never found things to fill, so assuming that that inventory menu was made with that many slots so that there is an item for each slot in the game somewhere, clearly I missed a few things, and maybe they add a little to the story? Color me doubtful. I don't know. This didn't really do anything for me. Except give me frustration and agita. So, check it out. It's on Steam. It is free. So apologies if I come across as harsh against a free product. It's just, as long as this took, it still costs the time to play, and because I do like to sort of, you know, conduct product advisory sorts of things so that I'm telling people what they should and should not spend, not just their money, also their time on. It's the latter that concerns me most about actually appealing to people as far as this game is concerned. So, yeah. Free to play. On Steam. I'll leave a link. Check it out if you're interested. I'm not. Hopefully you are. Comment if you had a different experience. Maybe there are multiple endings. I doubt it. I don't know. I'm Kinsmarck here at Decibel Press. Thank you all kindly for watching. And as always, I wish you all good gaming. You got this.